fellow citizens. I don't want anyone to see you. You've been looking so great.
Do you know how many fellows fake a little for sympathy? Only yours is a gold mine.
Help you down? Whoa!
What the fuck are you doing?
No, I put it down.
You'll be done with this soon enough. And take a moment. Drink in my penthouse. High above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
Look, because I like that breath of fresh air. Because I like seeing the sky and the stars.
Seeing stars, all right.
Those streets down there. They suck the life right out of my own head. Years of rotten jobs stomped on by bosses. And when they finally broke it, they tossed them to the curb like yesterday's paper. Well, they ain't doing that to me.
Everyone wants to come here.
New York's fine if those can afford a big, strong wall to lock it out. But I tell you, Crunchy, there's a whole other way out there. So you keep your small life in the big city. Give me a big way. Your small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away. To a little town down west that's spanking new. And while I ain't never been there, I can see it clear as day. If you want, I bet you could see it too. Close your eyes, jump with me. Clean and green and pretty, and they wanna need a city out of play. By the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son, welcome home to Santa Fe. The land's in drops, splitting rails, swapping tails around the fire, except for Sunday when you're
I need to sell this spot. How old are you? How did you get this?
A new kid.
I'm the kid, I'm the hard kid, rubs right off.
I'll take 20 new kids, please.
20 kids for the new kid.
Well, that's even nine.
I'll give you what it's sold.
Well, money good, come on, cash out.
Well, whenever I don't sell you my back, right?
Every single newsie would have to sell 10 more papers just to earn always.
My boss, exactly.
Jeez.
But it's going to be awfully rough on those children.
Awesome. I didn't know a real life lesson in economics. Why, I could offer them a better education if they were my own. Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army.
Thank you.
a doozy. Folks love it, and things have been going so well that I can actually pay.
No, I can never take your money, Miss Meadows.
Dad, can you really get to that? Your friend here. Why do you?
Take it easy, it's a bunch of treats.
But you're really good.
That boy's got natural aptitude.
Jeez, I never knew anyone with aptitude.
Miss Meadows, wrong.
Oh, yeah? How am I doing?
Welcome to Starbucks Show, Miss Meta Lockin!
I'm doing alright for myself, folks. I'm healthy, I'm wealthy, I'm wise. My investments in such have all gone up so much. Seems whatever I touch,
to be. The girls are nice, once awake all night. Sirens is all my speech. The longer they run, the better the headlines. The better the headline, the better I eat. The better I eat,
the further away from you I sleep.
You got a mutter? I was going to give me one.
What is the one you had?
He traded her a box of cigars.
They was Coronas.
We had a bottle too.
He gave him a med bottle.
Well, ain't me the point, boy.
So, how's it going today?
Why didn't you ask me after? They put up a headline.
Here, go now.
New Newsies price, 60 cents for 100.
Just say.
Is that news?
It's me.
It's Jack.
Even. us?
2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Just give me a water.
Why did I have this knife?
I say we watch our strike in the most auspicious manner. Anyone? No?
I don't know about that. But we shall skate the jeep is out of here!
Can you see the Lancey's being over here?
Alright, so what's next?
Well, now you gotta spread the word. Let the rest of the city's Lancey's know about the strike.
Alright, you heard the man. Split up. Spread the word.
I'll take that home. I got Midtown.
I got the Bronx.
And I got the Bowery.
Specs, you take Queens. Time for it? You take East Side. Who wants Brooklyn? Brooklyn! Spot the rumors first. Fitch! Tell me you're scared of Brooklyn?
I'm scared of turf. But that spot called makes me a little jittery.
By me and Dave, you will take Brooklyn.
Ain't no way.
Why is everyone so scared of Brooklyn?
What are you
doing? Asking a question. Have you got an answer?
Brooklyn is the sixth largest city in the world. You're with Brooklyn? You're in the month. For someone who works for the New York Sun, spending an awful lot of time hanging around at the White House. What was that? Following me?
Stop that.
The only thing I'm following is a story. The ragtag king of ragamuffins wanted to take on the kingmakers of New York. Think you have a chance?
Well, shouldn't you be in the ballet?
Question too difficult? I'll rephrase. Will the richest and most powerful men in New York give the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't got a nickel to their name?
Hey, you don't got a nickel. I got a nickel.
See you in the morning. Take off the rocket.
Hey, Plummer. Very good. We both got a lot riding on this.
Do you work the man?
Right, good.
Right, good, right back to him. Easy to do it in the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newbie, stop the world. Huh. A little high purple, you never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strip, there's another shadow curling in the city. I could just pray about it. Oh, come on, Catherine! Those boys are counting on you.
Oh, you poor boys.
Right, who knows what to say? All I know is I don't know.
Look, Mr. Brooklyn, and then they're with us.
They want to prove you
We can't just not show up for work. Jack, tell them if you back off now, they'll never listen to us again.
Fellas, you can't back off now. I don't trust enough to show. They got an announcement meeting in hand.
Like I said, just don't show up for work a couple days. They don't send a message.
They'll just replace us. They need to see us stand up around. Maybe.
Yeah. Stop, brand new, I need back.
Yeah!
My father had a union. This is Somebody we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up at the church.
Tell me how pretty this crochet is.
Well,
exactly. So, here's how it goes. Once we win, we will be winning the game for a state.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
All right.
So tell us who that. Then, of course, you're the king. Getting counted.
Dave, what the hell? Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked in one. Oh, come on. Here's what I think. Joe's a jerk. He's a rattlesnake.
You're right. You know why he's so scrappy?
No, why?
He's scared. So, going to the other four guys. That is kidding. Why can we send for the goons in entire world?
Shaped my life. Wars aren't won on the battlefield. It's the headline. decides to do.
I'll keep that in mind. New York is at the front page photos of our rally.
Rally till the cows come home. There's not a paper in town that will print a word. And if it's not in the papers, it never happens.
You may run the city, but there are some of us that can't be bullied, even some reporters.
You mean like that young woman that made you yesterday's news? Talented girl. Beautiful as well, don't you think?
Yeah, I'll tell you said so.
No need. She can hear for herself, can't you, darling? I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. Yes, my daughter. Now, I suppose you're asking, why the nom de plume and why doesn't she work for me? Excellent questions. Catherine, I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure. She chose instead to pursue a career, and she was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But you're done with all that now, aren't you, darling?
Kelly!
Now, dear, don't keep your problems on the boy. Mr. Kelly has a plateful of his own. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Does anyone feel a noose tightening? Let me allow me to offer you an alternate scenario. You attend the rally and speak out against this hopeless strike. And I'll see your criminal record expunged and line your pockets with enough cash to take you in a first-class compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say you wanted to travel west, didn't you?
There ain't a person in this room that don't know that you stink.
And they know me. They know I don't care. Mark my words, boy. Defy me, and I'll see you and all your little friends locked up in the refuge. I know you're Mr. Tough Guy, but would it be right to subject a little cripple boy to those conditions? And what about Davey and his little baby brother, ripped from a loving family and thrown to the rats? Could they ever thank you enough?
Time's running out, Peter. So what do you say?
How long, what kind of I live, either way, your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our guest to the cellar where he might reflect in solitude.
Scratch the head of you, Rusty.
Tonight, we declare that we are just as much a part of the newspaper companies as any reporter or editor. Tonight, we declare that we are done being treated like kids. From now on, they will treat us as equals.
Yeah!
I feel like an adult star acting. Just running out.
And here's Jack.
Raise the price of cash without so much of a word to us.
And that was a lousy thing to do.
Yeah!
We got mad. We showed it. We can be pushed around.
Yeah!
What do we do? We go on strike and pull it to lower the price of cash so we'll go back to work.
Yeah!
And a few weeks later, price the price back up again. And don't think we want to. What do we do then? And what do we do if we decide to raise the price again after that? Fellas, we gotta be realistic here. You don't work, you don't get paid. How many days can you go without making money? Believe me, go along, pull it to the longer. Now, but I have spoken with Mr. Pulitzer, and he has given me his word that if we disband the
union,
I say we take the deal so we can go back to our non-operated secure. All we gotta do is vote no.
Of course there is!
Well, look, they only happen every day!
Jack, I didn't
change anything. I just wish there was a way that I could grab hold of something so that I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly. I never even saw it coming.
Sure?
For sure.
Whoa.
here's how it'll go. Race. Once we start from the pace, you let the fellows in and they'll start handing them out to every important kid in the city. After that.
After that? Up to them. Thank you.
had a deal.
And it came with the money back guarantee. And thanks for your lesson on the power of the press.
Did you read that? Those kids put out pretty good paper.
No, that was written by my daughter.
I signed it before someone else got it.
I demand to know who defied my ban on printing strike to.
But your loyal employees. We never take our business elsewhere.
Oh, the old printing press in the cellar.
An agent can offer a life. Anyone who doesn't act in his own self-interest is a fool.
So what's that mean? This all started because you wanted to sell more papers. But you know how many circulations they also gave you sex? Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Guys like Joe don't talk to nothings like us. But a very wise person once told me, we're lost, we need audiences. So this wants to snatch at the red one when he hears it.
Torches! future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. And Jack, thanks to your drawings, there's another matter come to mind. Officers, if you please.
And look at Jack, it's crushing.
Oh! They're hard workers, and they really, I just have so much fun everywhere, so we get to like learn about the show and about each other, and it was cool. It was really cool. So thank you for like giving me your children to work with.